Sitting here with Fish, John Mesa. We're just getting packed up, finishing up the weekend, tying up all the loose ends. John, I appreciate everything you did, and I know you had a lot of help.
Thank you, Josh. First and foremost, I'd like to thank John Rob Holmes with Holmes Hobbies for being the title sponsor once again. I think it's 3 years running. And I also want to thank Jason and Badger with RC Crawler for giving us the awesome website and the support we need to make events like this happen. If it wasn't for RC Crawler, we probably wouldn't have a home. I also wanted to thank Dave and Susie with RCP for the lunch and the food that they brought on both Friday and Saturday for the judges and the competitors.
Yeah, that was great. And Dave and Susie, this is the second year in a row that I've seen them at Nationals, and they're always a lot of fun to hang out with.
She's also very helpful. She was running around with trash bags, and they had first aid kit. She was like fixing everybody up who got cut and scratched, and you know, all that good stuff.
We five core sponsors total.
Yes, we had Michelle with Crawler Concepts. She provided the signs. Lisa with Team DBed. They did the scorecards, which everybody seemed to love, and she also did the logo for the T-shirts and the core signs. And Matt with Voodoo Tires, he gave every competitor two free tires that they could redeem online, and he also brought donations for the giveaway, the raffle.
And he also he had a reward for the winner if they were using Voodoo Tires. And
won with the 2.2 Pro with Voodoo Tires.
It looks like he's got $500 coming his way.
Yep. We also had Rick, who could not attend, from Super Shafty, who gave us some cool prizes, which accidentally got left in my personal bag because a farmer brought them to me during the middle of the day. He was actually walking around in Prescott like a homeless guy because his phone died. But we'll do an online giveaway for those. It'll be open for all the competitors who were in attendance. Eddie O was in attendance from Team Brood Racing, and he gave out everybody a rebuild certificate. So it was really cool. It was really cool. A lot of good sponsors, a lot of them in attendance.
Yeah, the sponsors gave a lot of good prizes, and the giveaway lasted quite a while. We got a bunch of good shots of that. So I'll put something together to show everybody just how much sponsorship was shown there, and how much all the competitors enjoyed getting those things. I think the only person who I heard bitching was Hard Knocks, but he'll get over it.
But he's a good guy, so
yeah,
hopefully
he was helpful this weekend.
I'd also like to thank all the course builders who got up at before dark on Saturday, which made for a long, long day because we were there from before sunup and after sundown. And all the course builders, because the course build, from what I saw of the scores, we had a lot of drivers completing courses, but not everybody got the same score. We had
It was just a countdown of on the charts. That was a really neat just to see the distribution of points.
Yeah, if you look at the points, they go through the whole range. You know, there's not like any big grouping. It's distributed from all the way from 160 or 70, something like that, all the way down. Negative.
Yeah,
160 to 70, all the way up to, you know, your 28s. And
right.
So there was...
Our top 10 was separated by 22 points?
Top 10, 22 points, yes, that was correct. That's the reason why we decided to have a top 10 shootout as opposed to a top 5 shootout, because usually the 5th place person is not even mathematically possible to win, and here it is. We had people that was in the 10th place that was mathematically possible, but we didn't have a whole bunch of ties, so there was still a distribution of points, so right. It was really cool.
And the finals were a lot of fun to watch. You know, the rain played a part in that, which was tough, but everyone got through it, and it...
And actually the guy who ran first when the rain was the worst got the furthest.
Yeah.
And he just ran out of time. He was right there. He was...
Tom's Sourdough Jack. So yeah. I tried to get video of almost everything I could and pictures, but, you know, like you said, it was a downpour at that time, and I had run back to the trailer to try and switch equipment to get something that was waterproof, right. And I had missed his run. So, but still, congratulations on him. And he moved up a couple spots in the shootout.
Can't say the rain didn't affect the outcome, but it definitely wasn't the deciding factor, because he definitely moved up and he drove in the worst conditions. And the guys at the top, you know, they had the best conditions that was available.
Yeah, the final score really, it mixed some things up, but It, and it was, you know, we wanted that ability for that to happen. And
Yes, it was exactly. That was one of my requests, is to have movement, and we definitely had movement.
That was fun to watch, and I'll get some of that footage up here as soon as I can.
Staff level, comp staff level, I wanted to thank Brad for running water and picking up score sheets all day long. He didn't compete. He competed on Friday, but didn't compete on Saturday or Sunday. And he was just up and down, up and down, up and down on those rocks all day long, fetching score sheets, taking water. And I know it was a big help for me. John Ripplinger at SDS Customs, he's a workhorse. He did everything. I mean, he was setting up courses. He was judging. He was running water. He provided that great trailer that he mm-hmm. bought and had, you know, brought in and had air conditioning and power and a nice place to sit when it was raining.
Right,
it was
underneath just the awning. That was a lot of help, and I appreciate that too.
Yeah, that was a lifesaver. I don't know what we would have done if we had brought just an easy up with
right.
charging off car batteries. It would have been really bad. Art Bell, Palo Alto K5, you know, he was a good teammate. We're not on a team, but we're kind of like personal teammates. We just, you know, he drove around, picked up the car, shared a room. He just, and worked his ass off every day judging. So I was big thanks to him. Also like to thank William with RC Bros. He did the thankless job of entering the scores and
yep.
had probably close to 1,000 entries to enter, all in the rain while he was trying to run. People were talking to him, yelling at him, handing him wet score sheets.
Asking where they were at.
Yeah, asking what place they were in. It's just...
The live updates were great for everyone.
Yep.
You know, anyone with a smartphone could check their scores. So.
We did live updates last year, mm-hmm. but it seemed like William was just a little bit more active than we were last year mm-hmm. and, you know, definitely raised the bar up a little bit.
The location was beautiful. You know, it was the picturesque up on top of the hill, and then the rocks down right close to the parking lot there where we competed on Saturday and Sunday were great.
We probably wouldn't have been able to secure this location if it wasn't for Redliner Rob on the board. Rob Yagsma, he went down to the parks department, paid the deposit, you know, did the paperwork, got the thing, got the dates approved, helped secure all the campsites, and then on top of that, he provided me with his truck, an old Ford 150, and got to drive it around all weekend, and it was a lot of fun driving it, and it was big help just going and getting stuff and mm-hmm. water and ice and gas for the generators and just...
Anybody else you wanted to thank as far as help you had out there? I know I didn't get into town too early on Friday, so I missed a little bit of what was going on that day, but it looked like all that ran pretty smooth.
Well, Shane Scherzaba, I think I said that right.
I always throw an extra R in there just for make sure.
Scherzaba. Anyway, he helped out and planned and set up 2.2S. He was also very active in relief judging and all that. You know, I want to thank all the judges, as a matter of fact. Anybody just stepped up on a moment's notice, because with the rain and different things, their stuff was always changing. And so, you know, things just needed to be done at the drop of a hat, you know. And a lot of people just didn't wait. There were all those guys that just didn't wait. You know, Cameron Gilliam, Hilux on the board, was a classic example of somebody who just saw something that needed to be taken care of, took care of it, and then did it. He didn't, like, you know, stand around there with his arms crossed wondering what the heck was going on. He, you know, took the bull by the horns. And those guys are lifesavers, and, you know, we need more of those kind of guys at the comps. And we had a lot, but that was and I'm sure I'd forget it somebody, so if I tried to name them all. So,
well, it's been a great weekend fishing. I had a lot of fun, and we got a lot of pictures up. We've got, I'll make sure all the podium finishers have their pictures up. Anyone who's there to accept their trophy. And I know some guys had to leave, but, we'll make sure to get them recognized. Just congratulations to all the winners, and they did a great job. It was always amazing to watch those guys that are really that good.
Right. Yeah, they were amazing. I'd like to thank all the drivers. There were a lot of good drivers out there, and the courses took a toll on some of the top guys, and
mm-hmm.
we had some new names at the top, and we had some of the old standbys were a little bit further back, but I'm sure they'll be bounced back for next year, and they'll be right back up at the top.
Yeah.
So thanks.
Thank you, John, and we'll see you at the next one and sometime in the middle.
Yes, sir.
Progress.